Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor, Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject steam boilers. And this is lecture number 6 on the steam boiler. So we are going to discuss about the boiler performance. This is part 1 on the boiler performance. So boiler performance. So after installing the boiler, we have to conduct a test on the boiler to confirm the data. So the boiler is designed for a particular pressure and it is designed for a particular quantity of steam generation rate and efficiency. So all the data, whatever we design, that is to be verified by conducting the performance test. So the main performance parameters are evaporation rate, equivalent evaporation and boiler efficiency. The first parameter, evaporation rate. So this is the mass of steam produced per kg of fuel burnt in the boiler. So M equal to total steam generated divided by total fuel burnt, MS divided by MF. So where MS is the mass of the steam produced and MF is the mass of the fuel burnt. So unit is kilogram per kilogram of fuel. And the second parameter is equivalent evaporation. The equivalent evaporation is defined as the amount of water evaporated from water at 100 degree Celsius to dry saturated steam at 100 degree Celsius. Or simply we can put it like this. So the equivalent evaporation is defined as the amount of water evaporated from and at 100 degree Celsius. So ME equal to M into H minus HF1 divided by 2257, where M is the evaporation rate as we defined in the previous slide, evaporation rate in kilogram per kilogram of fuel, H is the enthalpy of the steam per kg under the generation condition. So for the given boiler outlet condition, H is the enthalpy of the steam and HF1 is the specific enthalpy of the water at the given feed water temperature. So water based on the water inlet temperature, HF1 equal to CPW into TW. So CPW is the specific heat of water and TW is the water inlet temperature. The specific heat of water, normally it will be given in the problem. If it is not given, you can take it as 4.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And 2257 is the constant, which is the latent heat of evaporation at 100 degree Celsius. So 100 degree Celsius is the reference point. So you can take the value from the steam table. So if you look at the steam table, so the latent heat of evaporation, that is HFG at 100 degree Celsius, is 2257 kilojoules per kilogram. And boiler thermal efficiency. So the boiler thermal efficiency defined as the ratio of heat absorbed by the steam to the amount of heat liberated by combustion of the fuel. So amount of heat given out by the fuel and amount of steam, amount of heat absorbed by the for generation of the steam. So eta B equal to MS, mass of the steam, into H minus HF1 divided by MF into calorific value, where MF is the mass of the fuel burnt and M is the steam generated per kg of the fuel. So M we define in the first slide. H is the enthalpy of the steam at the boiler outlet condition. HF1 is the enthalpy of water at feed water temperature. And the CV is the calorific value of the fuel in kilojoules per kilogram. So these three parameters are very important for calculating the boiler efficiency. There is one test called boiler trial or heat balance test is conducted on the boiler. So the heat is produced by burning the fuel. It may be coal. Normally in a large capacity steam power plant, we are burning the coal. So heat is produced by burning the fuel. Now we have to calculate how the heat is distributed. So there are different equipment available in the boiler. For example, evaporator, the economizer, air preheater, superheater, and there are some losses of heat energy and some amount of heat is carried away by the exhaust gases. So all these things we have to calculate, how the heat is utilized in the boiler by various components, that we have to calculate. And we have to balance between the amount of heat liberated by the combustion of the fuel and the amount of heat utilized effectively by the boiler components. That is what heat balance test, and the test is called as boiler trial. So the first parameter is amount of heat supplied by the fuel. So QS equal to MF into calorific value in kilojoules. So mass of the fuel into calorific value of the fuel. Then we have to calculate the amount of heat utilized for generation of the steam. So this we already defined, Q1 equal to MS, mass of the steam, into H minus HF, where H is the enthalpy of the steam in kilojoules per kilogram at a boiler outlet condition, and HF is the specific enthalpy of water in kilojoules per kilogram. And in percentage, so in terms of percentage, so Q1 by QS, so QS is the amount of heat supplied and the Q1 is the amount of heat utilized for generation of the steam into 100. That is what the percentage of heat utilized for generation of steam. And heat lost through the dry flue gases. Hot gases are leaving through the chimney to the atmosphere. So that is a waste. So the hot gas temperature is around 500 degrees Celsius. So the heat carried away by the flue gases. So Q2 equal to mg into CpG into Tg minus Ta. It is again in kilojoules, where mg is the mass of the gas formed per kg of fuel. What is the total quantity of gas formed? Normally, total quantity of gas formed equal to mass of the fuel or mass of the carbon plus mass of the air used for combustion. And CpG is the specific heat of gases, and Tg is the gas temperature, and Ta is the boiler room temperature or air temperature at the inlet of the combustion chamber. So in terms of percentage, so this equal to Q2 divided by QS into 100, where QS is the amount of heat supplied and the Q2 is the amount of heat used, heat carried away by the flue gases. And the heat loss due to the incomplete combustion. So there will be some amount of incomplete combustion in the combustion chamber. So we have to understand the combustion. So combustion is the chemical reaction between hydrocarbon in the fuel and air in oxygen in the air. So the any fuel is a hydrocarbon. So it contains hydrogen molecule and carbon molecule. Simple example. So you know methane. The chemical formula is CH4. Methane is a fuel where the chemical formula is CH4. So C is the number of carbon molecule and H is the number of hydrogen molecule. So when in the combustion process, the carbon molecule in the fuel combine with the oxygen, react with the oxygen, and it produces CO2. And hydrogen in the fuel, it is combining, chemically reacting with the oxygen in the air, that produces H2O. These are all the two popular combustion equation in the burning of the fuel. There are many more chemical reactions taking place, but these are all the two exothermic chemical reaction. What is exothermic chemical reaction? So during this chemical reaction, the heat is liberated in the process. There is opposite, the opposite process is called as endothermic chemical reaction, where heat is absorbed during the chemical reaction. Now, normally in a complete combustion process, the carbon is to be combined with the oxygen to produce CO2, carbon dioxide. Sometimes due to the non-availability of time factor, so the carbon may be released, combined and produces CO. That CO generation is called as incomplete combustion. So due to incomplete combustion, there will be loss of heat energy. So some amount of heat is wasted in the gases. So if you look at the equation, so 1 kg of carbon releases 10,200 kilojoules of heat if it burns to CO. When CO is formed, the amount of heat liberated per kg of the carbon is 10,200. Whereas 1 kg of carbon releases 35,000 kilojoules of heat if it burns to CO2. So where there is a loss, CO2 is the formation of CO2 is the complete combustion. Formation of CO is incomplete combustion. So loss of heat due to the incomplete combustion is 24,800 kilojoules. So heat loss to incomplete combustion of the carbon per kg of the fuel, Q3 equal to CO into C divided by CO plus CO2 into 24,800 in kilojoules. Where CO, CO2, they are the percentage of carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide in the flue gases by volume, and C is the percentage of carbon in the fuel by volume. So the fuel analysis data and the gas analysis data will be given in the problem you have to calculate. So the gas analysis is conducted by obtained from the RSAT apparatus, and the fuel analysis may be ultimate analysis or the ultimate analysis of the fuel. And in percentage, so this is equal to Q3 by Qs into 100. That is what the percentage of heat lost due to incomplete combustion. And heat loss due to the unburnt fuel. So due to the, so there are sometimes the fuel, it is left unburnt, completely it is not burnt. Some quantity of fuel is, some quantity of coal is lost in the ash pit. So the heat loss due to the unburnt fuel, so Q4 equal to MF1 into CV. So where MF1 is the mass of the unburnt fuel per kg of fuel, and CV is the calorific value of the fuel in kilojoules per kilogram. So in percentage, so the percentage of heat loss due to the unburnt fuel Q4 by Qs into 100. And the heat loss due to the moisture in the fuel. So, the fuel contains some quantity of moisture, air contains some quantity of moisture. So, because of that, there will be loss of heat energy. So, heat loss due to the moisture in the fuel. So, suppose the fuel is wet in the wet condition. So, there are some water particles available in the fuel. So, when you, first you have to heat the fuel so that there is some heat utilized for heating the fuel. So, the heat loss due to moisture in the fuel Q5 equal to M4 into enthalpy of the moisture in the gases minus enthalpy of water at the boiler room temperature. So, all these data we have to calculate from the steam table, and we have to calculate the amount of heat lost in the to the moisture in the fuel, where MW is the mass of the moisture in the fuel. And in terms of percentage, the percentage of heat loss due to the moisture in the fuel equal to Q5 divided by Qs into 100. And the heat unaccounted. So, there are other losses which we cannot directly measure. So, they are accounted as unaccounted heat losses. So, heat unaccounted equal to Qs minus sum of all the values Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 and Q5. And in terms of percentage, heat unaccounted divided by heat supplied into 100. So, we have given some set of equations to calculate various parameters. So, all the equations may not be applicable to a particular problem, because based on the data given, we have to select the appropriate equation, but all the other values will be counted in the unaccounted heat loss. So, when we solve a problem on the heat balance test on the boiler, you can understand the concept. And sometimes, in addition to the equations given, we may have some other heat loss in the boiler based on the operating condition and based on the type of the boiler. So, we have to calculate the amount of heat loss or heat utilization in the boiler, and we have to prepare the heat balance sheet for the boiler power plant. So, we stop here the theory part of the boiler performance. Now, we take example, the first example. In a boiler test, 1300 kg of coal are consumed in 24 hours. The mass of water evaporated is 13,000 kg and the mean effective pressure is 7 bar. The feed water temperature is 40 degrees Celsius and the calorific value of the coal is 30,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Determine equivalent evaporation per kg of coal and the boiler efficiency. Enthalpy of the steam at a 7 bar equal to 2570 kilojoules per kilogram. So, after reading the problem, you write down the given data. So, MF is the mass of the fuel. Mass of the fuel burned 1300 kg in 24 hours, and the MS is the mass of the water evaporator or mass of the steam produced 13,000 kg per 24 hours. Steam pressure is 7 bar at the outlet condition. Water temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. Calorific value of the fuel is 30,000 kilojoules per kilogram, and the enthalpy of the steam for 7 bar equal to 2570 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the mass of the steam produced per kg of the fuel, that is evaporation rate, M equal to mass of water evaporated divided by the mass of the fuel used equal to MS divided by MF equal to 13,000 divided by 1300, which is 10 kg per kg of the coal. And we calculate the heat required for producing 1 kg of the steam, that is equal to H minus H of 1. So, H is the enthalpy of the steam minus H of 1 is the specific heat of water at the boiler entry condition. So CPW into delta TW. So 2570 minus 4.187 into 40 equal to 2402.52 kilojoules per kilogram. And the equivalent evaporation, so ME, the equation we have to remember, M into H minus HF1 divided by 2257. So H minus HF1 we have calculated earlier. So 10 into 2402.52 divided by 2257 equal to 10.64 kg per kg of coal. And the boiler efficiency, eta B equal to MS into H minus HF1 divided by MF into calorific value, where MS by MF equal to M equivalent evaporation rate. So M into H minus HF1 divided by CV, which is equal to 10 into 2402.52 divided by 30,000 into 100 equal to 80.1%. So the equivalent evaporation is 10.64 kg per kg of coal, and boiler efficiency is 80.1%. And we take the next example. So the following data obtained from a boiler trial of 6 hours. Mean steam pressure is 15 bar. Mass of the steam generated is 40,000 kilogram. Drainage fraction of the steam is 0.86. Feed water temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. Coal used is 4,000 kilogram. Calorific value of the coal is 33,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Find the factor of evaporation, equivalent evaporation, and boiler efficiency. So after reading the problem, we write down the given data. So given data are, boiler trial period is 6 hours. Pressure is 15 bar. Mass of the steam produced is 40,000 kilogram per 6 hours. X equal to 0.86. Water temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. Mass of the fuel burnt is 4,000 kilogram. And calorific value of the coal is 33,000 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the evaporation rate or mass of the steam produced per kg of the fuel. M equal to mass of water evaporated divided by mass of the fuel used. So MS divided by MF equal to 40,000 divided by 4,000 equal to 10 kg per kg of coal. And from the steam table, at 15 bar pressure, HF equal to 844.6 kilojoules per kilogram and HFG equal to 1945.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So enthalpy of the steam at the boiler exit condition, H equal to HF plus X into HFG, which is 844.6 plus 0.86 into 1945.3 equal to 2517.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the enthalpy of water at the inlet of the boiler. HF1 equal to CPW into delta TW, so 4.187 into 30 equal to 125.61. And the factor of evaporation, Fe equal to H minus HF1 divided by 2257. So 2517.6 minus 125.61 divided by 2257 equal to 1.06. That is the factor of evaporation. And the equivalent evaporation equal to, either you can use this equation or this ME equal to M into FE, that is also possible. So M into H minus HF1 divided by 2257. So substituting 10 into 2517.6 minus 125.61 divided by 2257 equal to 10.6 kg per kg of fuel. And the boiler efficiency, eta B equal to MS into H minus HF1 divided by MF into calorific value, which is equal to M into H minus HF1 divided by CV, which is 10 into 2517.6 minus 125.61 divided by 33,000 equal to 72.48%. So there is the boiler efficiency. The example number 3, the following data refer to a boiler plant. Mass of water evaporated per hour 5940 kilogram. Mass of the coal burnt is 675 kilogram. Calorific value of the coal is 32,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Feed water temperature at economizer inlet is 32 degrees Celsius. Feed water temperature at the economizer exit is 115 degrees Celsius. Steam pressure is 14 bar. Drainage fraction of the steam leaving the boiler is 0.96. Temperature of the steam leaving the superheater is 260 degrees Celsius. The specific heat of the superheated steam is 2.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Determine the percentage of heat used in the economizer, boiler, superheater and overall plant efficiency. And we have to write down the given data. So mass of the steam produced 5940 kilograms per hour. Mass of the fuel used 675 kilograms per hour. Calorific value of the fuel 32,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Mass of feed water, temperature of the feed water is water temperature at the economizer inlet is 32 degrees Celsius. Water temperature at the economizer outlet is 115 degrees Celsius. The steam pressure at the outlet of the boiler is 14 bar. Drainage fraction is 0.96. Temperature of the steam at the outlet of the superheater 260 degrees Celsius and specific heat of the steam is 2.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. First, we calculate the heat produced by burning the coal. So, amount of heat produced QS equal to MF into CV, which is 675 into 32,000 equal to 21.6 in 10 power 6 kilojoules per hour. That is the amount of heat produced in kilojoules per hour. And this is the arrangement. So, we have the economizer, evaporator of the boiler and the superheater. The water is entering the economizer at 32 degrees Celsius. And it is heated using the flue gases. It is heated and water is leaving at temperature 115 degrees Celsius and it enters the evaporator. In the evaporator, the water is converted into steam at a saturation temperature of 195 degrees Celsius for the boiler operating pressure. And it enters the superheater where it is leaving the superheater with the temperature of 260 degrees Celsius. Now, we have to calculate heat utilized in the three devices, economizer, evaporator and the superheater. And in the heat used in the economizer, so Q1 equal to MW CPW into TW2 minus TW1. So, MW is 5940, CPW is 4.187, TW2 is 115 minus 32 equal to 2.06 into 10 power 6 kilojoules per hour. And the percentage of heat used in the economizer, so Q1 by QS into 100 equal to 2.06 in 10 power 6 divided by 21.6 into 10 power 6 equal to 9.53%. And the heat used in the boiler for producing the steam. So, Q2 equal to MS into H minus HF, where H is the enthalpy of the steam at the boiler outlet. HF is the enthalpy of water at the boiler inlet. So, enthalpy of water at the boiler inlet temperature. So, evaporator inlet temperature is 115 degrees Celsius. So, HF equal to CPW into TW2 equal to 4.187 into 115 equal to 481.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And the amount of the enthalpy from the steam table at a 14 bar pressure, HF equal to 830.1 kilojoules per kilogram. HFG equal to 1957.7 kilojoules per kilogram. Hg equal to 2787.8 kilojoules per kilogram and saturation temperature is 195 degree Celsius. The specific enthalpy of the steam at the boiler outlet. So, boiler outlet it is wet steam. So, Hg equal to Hf plus x into Hfg. So, which is equal to 830.1 plus 0.96 into 1957.7 equal to 2709.49 kilojoules per kilogram. And the amount of heat utilized in the boiler. Q2 equal to MS into H minus HF, which is 5940 into 2709.49 minus 481.5 equal to 13.23 into 10 power 6 kilojoules per hour. And in percentage, the percentage of heat used in the boiler, Q2 by QS into 100, which is 13.23 into 10 power 6 divided by 21.6 into 10 power 6 equal to 61.25%. And the heat used in the superheater, so, Q3 equal to MS into H2 minus H1. So, H2 is the enthalpy of the steam at the outlet of the superheater. H1 is the specific enthalpy of the steam at the entry of the superheater, which we already calculated. So, the boiler outlet enthalpy is equal to superheater inlet enthalpy. So, for H2, so H2 equal to Hg2 plus Cp into T2 minus Ts2, it is superheated steam. So, 2787.8 plus 2.1 into 260 minus 195 equal to 2924.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate Q3, amount of heat utilized in the superheater. So, MS into H2 minus H1. So, 5940 into 2924.3 minus 2709.49 equal to 1.27 in 10 power 6 kilojoules per hour. And the percentage of heat utilized in the superheater. So, equal to Q3 by QS into 100. which is equal to 1.27 in 10 power 6 divided by 21.6 in 10 power 6 equal to 5.87%. And the overall efficiency of the plant, so Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 divided by Qs, amount of heat supplied into 100, so 2.06 plus 13.23 plus 1.27 into 10 power 6 divided by 21.6 into 10 power 6 into 100 equal to 76.67%. So, remaining roughly 23% of heat energy is wasted in the exhaust gases. So, this is the overall plant efficiency. We stop here, and these are all the books I have published earlier. So, you can refer to it: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures for all the subjects for your better learning. You use the videos for repeatedly for your to learn better. And also, I upload the solution for the GATE question paper in the YouTube channel. You refer to it and pass in the GATE examination for your better future. So, thank you for watching the video. And you please post your comments on the comments box, and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. I will answer to your queries. Thank you. We'll meet again with additional problems in the next video.